Pascal's law says that pressure applied to an enclosed fluid will be transmitted without a change in magnitude to every point of the fluid and walls of the container. The pressure at any point in the fluid is equal in all directions. So for example, you are taking a small area and small amount of force you are applying. The pressure here and also on the large area and large amount of force will be the resulting. Okay, pressure here and pressure here is equal. That is what Pascal's law. So if you take P1 is equal to P2, so P1 is F1 by A1 and P2 is F2 by A. Okay, so this is the basic formula of Pascal's law, and some of the derived formulae you can also do. If you take circular disc, this piston disc radius is R1, then area 1 becomes pi R1 square and area 2 becomes pi R2 square. Then pi pi gets cancelled. Then another formula is F1 by R1 square is equal to F2 by R2 square. And if you take in terms of diameter, R1 is nothing but D1 by 2, R2 is nothing but D2 by 2. Then if you simplify, this 2 square, A by B by C, you can write it as AC by B. In the same way, this in the denominator, there is a fraction again. This 2 square, if you send it to numerator, it becomes 4. Okay, and 4 gets cancelled. And another derived formula is F1 by D1 square is equal to F2 by D2 square. These three are Pascal's law only. Okay. Where R1 is the radius of the piston 1, or D1 is the radius of the piston 1, R2 is the radius of the piston 2, D2 is the radius of diameter of the piston 2, A1, A2, A1 is the area of the piston 1, small area, A2 is the large area piston, and F1 is the small amount of load which you are applying on the small area, and F2 is the resultant output area, output force.